Good evening and welcome to the Jazz Band Concert. I just want to do a volume check. If someone would mind just typing into the box to make sure that you can hear me okay, that would be much appreciated. Thank you, Julian. Julie, okay, great, awesome, okay. Welcome to the Jazz Combos Concert here at Albright College. We are live streaming through YouTube. And my name is Kelly Powers. I am the jazz band director here at Albright College. Tonight we have an exciting program for you. We'll be featuring two different combos. The first one is going to feature vocalist Cassie Thornton, bassist Michael Gruber, and drummer Justin Stricker. The second combo will feature the trumpeter Brandom Hernandez, trombonist Shelby Woodard, baritone horn player Natalie Paschket, piano player Megan Ordakowski, again the bass player Michael Gruber, and drummer Noah Sellman. We are going to be kicking things off with a tune called Lullaby of Birdland. This is a very well-known jazz standard and popular song composed by George Shearing with lyrics by George David Weiss. It was written for the famous jazz club in New York City, located on 44th Street, called Birdland. And this combo's arrangement features our very talented vocalist, Cassie Thornton, who was inspired by the legendary Sarah Vaughan. The original recording was from 1954 and included bebop trumpeter Clifford Brown. In Sarah Vaughan's rendition, her scat singing was very heavily influenced by bebop style, and you could hear her trade with various instruments like the flute, sax, and trumpet. Anyone who's unfamiliar with scat singing, what that means is it's improvisation with wordless vocables, nonsense syllables, or without words at all. In scat singing, the singer improvises melodies and rhythms using the voice as an instrument rather than a speaking medium. Anyway, so this combo featuring Cassie, Michael, and Justin, you can hear that this group transcribed and incorporated the intro from the Sarah Vaughan's version into their own arrangement. Cassie actually studied piano with me last semester, and we talked a lot about chords and harmony. She learned what we call shell tones or guide tones. And we talked a lot about, you know, how to accompany herself. It's a great way to kind of hear, to kind of learn how to be able to improvise if you can really learn the harmony. So in this rendition, you'll hear the head, which in jazz we call, the main melody is called the head, and then you'll hear the scat solo. So I hope you enjoy. Let's kick things off.
And then we'll go higher than the Berlin, higher in the sky above our love. Da 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 da. Cha-cha-cha-cha-wa-wa-wa-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- that's what I always see. And when you sigh, never in my world could there be ways to reveal in a phrase how I feel. And have you ever to a turtle dove's feeling cool? When we love, and that's the kind of magic of music we make with our lips when we kiss. And there's a weepy all we know, and he really knows how to cry. And that's how I cry on my pillow. If you should tell me farewell and goodbye, lullaby a pearl and whisper low, and kiss me sweet, and then we'll go.
All right. Could you all hear that music okay? Could you type in the box if you could hear that okay? All right, great. Thank you very much. All right. So yeah, let's give it up for our first combo there. Stellar performance. And I just wanted to give a shout out also to our very dedicated and talented audio engineer. Huge shout out and thank you to Veronica Jakubowski, who did a tremendous job helping us record all the songs for the concert. All right, so next we'd like to continue with a jazz bossa nova. This tune is called Ceora, and it was written by the great trumpeter Lee Morgan in 1965. The song first appeared on Morgan's album Cornbread, which features the trumpeter playing alongside pianist Herbie Hancock, drummer Billy Higgins, saxophonist Jackie McLean and Hank Mobley, and bassist Larry Ridley. Though the album was recorded in 1965, it was released 2 years later in 1967 on the Blue Note label. In this version, you'll hear our rhythm section locking down the jazz bossa nova feel. Our featured soloists include Brandom Hernandez on trumpet and Shelby Woodard on the trombone. And these, I just wanted to mention too, the first song you heard and this song were both recorded in CFA 213 in the music building and for the Center of Fine Arts. And the concert is a compilation of recordings that were made throughout the semester in the recording studio. So once again, we have combo number two with Brandom Hernandez, Shelby Woodard, Natalie Paschket, Megan Ordakowski, Michael Gruber, and Noah Sellman. Here is Ceora. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. Give it up. And you can feel free to type in the box if you could do some virtual clapping or compliments or feedback. There you go. So yes, that was the tune Ceora, performed by Combo Number 2, which is a sextet. As you can see, we have three horns and the full rhythm section with piano, bass, and drums. Next we'll be continuing. We're going to kind of alternate back and forth between the two combos. So now we're going to go back to combo number one. And we'll be listening to the combo's version of the tune All of Me, which is a very well-known jazz standard, an old jazz standard, not to be confused with the modern day pop tune by John Legend, All of Me. This is the old jazz standard. And it was written by Gerald Marks and Seymour Simons in 1931. But the version that we were inspired by and that the students wanted to arrange after was Billie Holiday's version, recorded in 1941. That is probably the most notable and definitive version of all time, is Billie Holiday's. This rendition will feature our vocalist, Cassie Thornton. You can hear, just like in any good jazz vocalist, Cassie takes initiative and embellishes the melody. Through all of our rehearsals, I would encourage Cassie to sing the melody slightly different each time we ran the tune. I think it's really important in jazz not to just sing a melody straight from the page, but it is important to express yourself as an individual. And jazz really should celebrate the uniqueness and individual that the uniqueness that the individual has to offer. We as people are always changing moods, and we are alive and human, not robots. And we need to keep the music humanistic too. So you will hear a scat solo followed by a piano solo. And then you will hear a bass solo by our very talented Michael Gruber. So here is All of Me, and I hope you enjoy.
The best, why not take all the rest?
Stop the share for just a moment. We take a poll. Feel free to leave comments. And just FYI, I mean, the solos that you heard were all improvised. In jazz, we love to improvise. So the piano solo, the bass solo, the scat singing is all improvised. And just this, these students did a tremendous job this semester. We had a hybrid course. So some of the rehearsals were live and in person. And obviously the recording sessions were live and in person. And we did Zoom rehearsals. Some of the students would get together and send videos to me. So just really creative ideas flowing, and the commitment and dedication by these students were just tremendous this semester. I'm so, so proud of them. Let's do a poll. Let's see if I can do this. Okay. Poll number one, which I was told to do halfway through, then we'll do another one at the end. And hopefully you can see that. And we'll just wait another couple minutes. Okay, so I have 45 out of 55 voted. Oh, still coming in, 46 out of 55. All right, give it another minute. All right, looks like most of you did pretty well. Let's go over the answers. So does scat imitate real instruments? Yes, yes, it does. Trumpet, drums, flute, when you hear those scat syllables, they're actually imitating the instruments. And then is number two, is Ceora a Latin-based composition? Yes, it is. Yes, it is, bossa nova. And number three, who made the song All of Me famous? Was it Billie Holiday or Ella Fitzgerald? And most of you got it right. The answer is Billie Holiday. All right, excellent. So I'm going to end this poll. And let's move on with the concert. So go back to my screen share. Here we go. Next, we're going to be continuing with, look at my notes here, a tune called Mr. PC. And we will go back to our combo number two, which is the sextet with the three horns in the rhythm section. We will be playing this tune, Mr. PC, for you. It is a 12-bar jazz piece in a minor blues form, composed by the great legendary John Coltrane in 1959. The song is named in tribute to the great bass player Paul Chambers, who had accompanied Coltrane for years. It first appeared on the album Giant Steps, where it played with a very fast swing feel. This will feature our entire group, and our soloists will include Shelby Woodard on trombone, Megan Ordakowski on piano, Michael Gruber on bass, and Brandom Hernandez on trumpet. You will hear all kinds of blues language in this tune. When you hear the improvising, you'll hear the incorporation of blues language. And you really can't call music jazz unless it has two things, the element of improvisation and some of that blues language. It has to have those two things in order to be considered or qualify as jazz music. So here you go. Here's Mr. PC. Hope you enjoy it. And here we go. Minor blues, lots of improv, swinging. So once again, I hope you enjoyed that. That tune was called Mr. PC, featured Brandom Hernandez on trumpet, Natalie Paschket on baritone horn, Shelby Woodard on trombone, Megan Ordakowski on piano, Michael Gruber on bass, and Noah Sellman on the drums. Fantastic job. We're going to move on to our last tune, actually. We have just a short program, but a good program for you tonight. I just want to give a special thanks to my music department chair for all his help this semester, Mike DiRico. He helped tremendously with the final production of the concert and was very supportive throughout the semester. Also, special shout out to AG Merlino, who helped make sure things would run smoothly through Zoom and YouTube tonight. Lastly, I'd like to thank the provost, Karen Campbell, and president, Jackie Fritro, for helping having me as director of the jazz band here at Albright College. I'm so proud of all my students' hard work during this very challenging semester dealing with coronavirus. They've been motivated, made masks for themselves and their instruments, ran the air purifiers and rehearsed in person, sent me videos, met on Zoom. It's just amazing and inspiring as a teacher to see the dedication. And I've just really seen some serious growth, not as just musicians, but as people. So I've really enjoyed working with each and every individual in the jazz combos. And we will be finishing with a tune called Don't Know Why. This was a cover recorded by American singer Nora Jones from her debut studio album Come Away With Me, recorded in 2002. The single went on to win 3 Grammy Awards in 2003 for Record of the Year, Song of the Year, and Best Female Pop Vocal Performance. It remains Jones's biggest hit single in the U.S. to date, and the only one to reach the top 40 of Billboard's Hot 100. This will feature our very talented vocalist, Cassie Thornton. She came to me in rehearsal one day and said, "Hey, professor, what if we tried this song?" I told her, "Yeah, that'd be great. Just go look for the music." She came back the next rehearsal and she had taken it upon herself to write out a chart based on just listening by ear to the tune and arranged it for the band. Luckily, she didn't have to transpose keys because the key fit her key, the exact original with Nora Jones. So it made it a little easier, but just tremendous effort. Justin and Michael also took to it really fast and did such a good job with it. And I really hope you enjoyed the concert tonight. Without further ado, let's listen to our closer called Don't Know Why. And again, this features Cassie Thornton on vocals, Michael Gruber on bass, and Justin Stricker on the drums. Enjoy.
My heart is drenched.
something has to make it right. Don't know why I didn't come, and I feel as empty as a drum. Don't know why I didn't come, and I don't know why I didn't come. I don't know why I didn't come.
Bravo, bravo, bravo. Thank you once again for attending the Albright College Jazz Combos Concert. I am going to run one more poll before we say our final goodbye. Poll number two. There we go. Just a couple more minutes. 45 out of 55, 81% voted. Let's see. And one more minute. All right, 100% done. Okay, great. So first question, Mr. PC was written for, was it Paul Chambers or Phil Collins? And most of you got this correct. Paul Chambers. Paul Chambers is the answer. Number two, what artist recorded Don't Know Why in 2002 and won 3 Grammys, including Record of the Year, Song of the Year, and Best Female Pop Vocal Performance? Was it Nora Jones, Diana Krall, or Cecile McLaurin-Salvon? And most of you got this correct. The answer is Nora Jones. And third question, jazz always uses blues language and improvisation, true or false? And the answer is true. End poll. All right. Well, I'm Kelly Powers, director of the jazz band here at Albright College. I hope you enjoyed our program tonight. A little different this year with the live stream, but we're always creative and improvising and making things come together and making things happen. So I hope you enjoyed the program. One more hand for these amazing students. Tremendous work this semester. And I hope everyone out there has a safe and healthy and happy holiday season. And I will see you all in the spring. Take care and thanks for coming out and have a great night.